My greetings, dear students. In this video, we will learn some applications of Wilson theorem. So as you see, I have written the statement of a numerical. Given a prime number p, establish this congruence. Now to prove this, given p is a prime number, so by Wilson theorem, we have p minus 1 factorial is congruent minus 1 modulo p. Now see, we need to prove modulo 1, 2, 3, so on up to p minus 1. So for this, how can we proceed? So we write this as p minus 1 into p minus 2 factorial congruent minus 1 mod p. And as we know, p minus 1 is congruent minus 1, congruent minus 1 mod p, which very easily may be written as p minus 2 factorial congruent 1 mod p. So from here, using definition of congruences, we have that p divides p minus 2 factorial minus 1, which further imply p divides twice of this. We can easily multiply minus 1 with this, minus 2 with this, or as GCD of p and p minus 1 is 1. So we can write p into p minus 1 also divides 2 is to p minus 1 p minus 2 factorial minus 1. We can multiply by p minus 1 on both sides. So next, as you see, this is p is to p minus 1. Now if p is prime, so clearly p minus 1 is not prime. And also we can have that these two are consecutive numbers, and product of two consecutive numbers is always even. So this must be divisible by 2. So if this is divisible by 2, so we may write it as p is 2, p minus 1 by 2 divides. So this 2 will cancel. So we will take this p minus 1 inside. So p minus 1 into p minus 2 factorial minus p minus 1. And further, this may be written as p is 2 p minus 1 by 2 factorial. So this becomes p minus 1 factorial minus p minus 1. So in term of congruence, this is p minus 1 factorial is congruent p minus 1 modulo p is 2 p minus 1 by 2. Modulo p is 2 p minus 1 by 2. Now as you see, this is 1 plus 2 plus 3 so on p minus 1. So if you remember sum of n natural numbers, the formula is n is to n plus 1 by 2. Now we can use that formula for n minus 1 number also. Just we have to replace n by n minus 1. So similarly here, this is the sum of p minus 1 numbers. So the sum is equal to p is to p minus 1 by 2. So this may further be written as p minus 1 factorial congruent p minus 1 modulo 1 plus 2 plus so on p minus 1. Hence the answer. Next numerical. If p is a prime, prove that for any integer a, p divide this as well as p divide this. Now we have Fermat theorem as well as Wilson theorem. So first we will write that if p is a prime and a is any integer, by corollary of Fermat theorem, we have a power p is congruent a mod p. And by Wilson theorem, we have p minus 1 factorial congruent minus 1 mod p. So these will be the results that we make use here, and we convert this into a congruence. So we have to prove a power p plus p minus v 1 factorial into a is concurrent 0 mod p. Let us take left hand side, a power p plus p minus 1 factorial a. Now, using the results here and reducing this modulo p, a power p is concurrent a and p minus 1 factorial is concurrent minus 1. What is this? Concurrent to 0, which is the desired result. I hope you can understand how we have done this. So similarly, we will get here, we need to prove p minus 1 factorial into a power p plus a is concurrent 0 mod p. So for this, we start with the left hand side, p minus 1 factorial a power p plus a is concurrent to, and p minus 1 factorial is minus 1, and a power p is concurrent a plus a modulo p, which is concurrent 0 mod p, and which is the desired result. Next numerical, verify that this is divisible by 31. So means to say, we have to prove 4 into 29 factorial plus 5 factorial is concurrent 0 modulo 31. This is to prove. Now to prove this, as we know, 31 is a prime number by Wilson theorem. We have 30 factorial concurrent minus 1 modulo 31. So once we write this, we will see we can easily make 30 factorial to 29 factorial. So we will write it as 30 into 29 factorial minus 1 modulo 31. And next, 30 is concurrent minus 1 into 29 factorial minus 1 modulo 31, which may further be written as 29 factorial concurrent 1 mod 31. Now as you see, we need 4 into this, so multiplying by 4 on both sides, 4 times 29 factorial concurrent 4 modulo 31. And what else we need? 5 factorial. So adding 5 factorial on both sides, 4 into 29 factorial plus 5 factorial. And as we know, 5 factorial is 120 plus 4, which is 124, and 124 is concurrent 0 modulo 31, which is the desired answer. Next numerical, prove that if P and P plus 2 are pair of twin primes, twin prime means both are primes, we need to prove this concurrence. So here, given P and P plus 2 both are primes, so applying Wilson theorem. First for P, we will get P minus 1 factorial is concurrent minus 1 mod P. And now for P plus 2, we will get P plus 1 factorial is concurrent minus 1 modulo P plus 2. So we will solve these separately. As you see, in the result, we need to prove modulo P is to P plus 2 because they are relatively prime. So we prove this concurrence for P as well as P plus 2. Then we will combine them. So what we need here? We need plus 1. So adding 1 on both sides, P minus 1 factorial plus 1 is concurrent. So 1 minus 1, 0 mod P. And next we need multiple of 4. So multiply by 4 on both sides. So 4 is to 0, 0. And next, plus P. So adding P on both sides. And here, when you add P, P modulo P is again 0 mod P. So we have completed one part. We named this 1. Now in the other part, we have to see. First, we convert this into P minus 1. For that, we will write it as P plus 1 into P plus 1. into p minus 1 factorial minus 1 modulo p plus 2. So as you see, p plus 1 is concurrent minus 1 and p is concurrent minus 2 modulo p plus 2. And further, so it will be 2 into p minus 1 factorial, and taking this 1 to other side, this is plus 1 0 modulo p plus 2. Now you see what we need this. So here we don't have 2 here, to make 2 common, what can we do here? We just write 1 as 2 minus 1. So we write this 2 as 2 minus 1. So taking 2 common, so this is p minus 1 factorial plus 1 minus 1 concurrent 0 mod p plus 2. Now to make this 4, we again multiply by 2 on both sides. 4 times p minus 1 factorial, so 2 here, 0 mod p plus 2. And next we need p here, so adding p on both sides. 4 p minus 1 factorial plus 1 plus p minus 2 concurrent to p modulo p plus 2. Now taking this 2 on the other hand side, so it will be p plus 2. 4 into p minus 1 factorial plus 1 plus p, so it will be p plus 2, which is 0 modulo p plus 2. Now this is number 2. Now combining 1 and 2, we get 4 into p minus 1 factorial plus 1 plus p concurrent 0 modulo p into p plus 2.